Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I'm not afraid to die.
Nityananda Ram, Nityananda Ram, Ki Jai, Sri Sri Nityananda Trayodashi Mahamahatsav Ki Jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Jai. Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai Nityananda.
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai
Nityananda.
Jai Jai Sri
Chaitanya Jai Nityananda.
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai
Nityananda.
Jai Advaita Chandra Jai Gaura Bhakta Vrinda.
Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, Gaura Bhakta Vrinda,
Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, Gaura Bhakta Vrinda.
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda,
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda.
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai Nityananda,
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai Nityananda.
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai Nityananda.
Jai Jai
Sri Chaitanya Jai Nityananda. Jai Advaita Chandra Jai Gaura Bhakta Vrinda.
Jai Advaita Chandra Jai Gaura Bhakta Vrinda.
So, it is customary that first we discuss the tattva of the Lord, and then that we discuss pastimes of the Lord, characteristics of the Lord, and so on. But before we turn to the tattva of Lord Nityananda, we just want to approach Lord Nityananda in a prayerful mood. You have to go, no problem. This guy's kind of problem. I was good. Then we'll start again. So, we want to approach the Lord in a prayerful mood. Because trying to collect for a new microphone. No problem. Okay. In a prayerful mood. The very fact that we're able to make offense, that we're able to make advancement, is simply because offenses are not considered. Otherwise, it would be impossible. When we begin to understand the actual position of the Vaishnavas and what an amazing culture there is amongst the Vaishnavas of taking a humble position and of offering all respects to others, it takes a long time to absorb that. So therefore we can see how the mercy of Lord Nityananda is acting in our lives. not only by bringing Krishna consciousness to us, but also while we are practicing, you see. Otherwise, it would be impossible. So this whole movement operates on the mercy of Lord Nityananda to counteract all the offenses that we commit and the whole lack of culture that is there. And somehow or other, we are making it. It begins there. It begins there because this is the desire of the Supreme Lord. It is the desire of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to deliver all the conditioned souls. Lord Nityananda, Chaitanya Charitamrita said, is always serving the Supreme Lord. Ekala Ishvara or Sarvabhicha. Lord Nityananda is Nityananda Balaram. And Balaram is non-different from Krishna. Krishna and Balaram are the same. And the Jumna Maharaj said they are the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Advaita. Advaita achutam anadim anantarupam. But they also have unlimited forms. And the moods are distinctly different because Lord Chaitanya is acting as Krishna, who is Savior Bhagavan. He is the objective of all service. And Lord Nityananda, he is Sevak Bhagavan. He is fully absorbed in service. It is said that Lord Balaram, or Lord Nityananda, non-different, is the manifestation of the Sandini Shakti, or of the existence potency of Krishna. Therefore, all existence rests on him, beginning with the spiritual world, and then the material world also. Beginning with Nityananda expanding himself in the form of Mahasankarsan, and then from there, so many other forms are coming. Lord Ananta is manifesting. Ananta with his unlimited mouth, who are all glorifying the Supreme Lord. And yet no end is coming to it. So this is the nature of Nityananda. He's just chanting and chanting, absorbed in glorifying Krishna, either directly or spreading the glories of Krishna everywhere. That is the nature of Lord Nityananda. He is always eager to glorify Lord Chaitanya. Therefore, the power for chanting the holy name is directly attained by the mercy of Lord Nityananda. It begins there. Because even when we know that the holy name should be chanted, even if we know that all benefit will come, the cartoon that Prabhupada was so often referring to, chant, 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 says this old lady to her husband, and he says, can't, can't, can't. Right. And Prabhupada liked it so much, he had it photocopied and sent all over the world. Right? Yes, it was Prabhupada's favorite cartoon. Yeah, because, so what if we can't chant? What if it's just too difficult? Just can't do it. Then what? Then by the mercy of Lord Nityananda, we can. So we assist Lord Nityananda in service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Lord Nityananda is besides providing the spiritual world, also providing menial service to the Lord. He becomes the bed of the Lord, the seat of the Lord, the crown of the Lord. Everything that the Lord requires, the Lord becomes. When Lord Chaitanya is a Brahmana, and this is still in Navadvip, in his Grihastha days, right, then Lord Ananta becomes the Brahmin thread. Broad chest of the Lord. Nityananda is his Brahmin thread. in this way, in this way, we can appreciate that the Lord is somehow or other always serving. And because of that service, Lord Nityananda is tasting extraordinary bliss, a very great bliss, a great happiness. And it is said in Chaitanya Charitamrita that due to this bliss, he becomes intoxicated, so much so that he can no longer distinguish who is qualified and who is not. And therefore, he gives it to anybody, gives the mercy to all, without considering who they are, where they are, what they know, what they don't know. So yeah, that sounds good for us. So my prayer is that somehow or other, Lord Nityananda will never withdraw his mercy from all of us. It's because without his mercy, how can we be successful? Even when we are in Vrindavan, even when we can hear about exalted pastimes, but how degraded are we deep down inside in what is described as the innermost chambers of the heart, the hidden portion of the heart, the dark corner of the heart. Don't want to go there. Something like the dark. You don't want to go there. The dark corners of the heart. Stay away. Yeah, so in this way, by the mercy of Nityananda, we are getting taste, you see. So that taste will give us the strength, because austerity has already been destroyed. Kali has broken the legs of the Bull Dharma, and the leg of austerity was already broken. Yes. The leg of cleanliness already broken. Which one? The cleanliness? What? Don't say blah, blah. Say it clear. Don't speak marbles. There's four. There's truthfulness, there's cleanliness, austerity, and mercy, compassion. Thank you. Compassion. So they were all broken. Compassion gone. Gone. Cleanliness, that meant illicit sex. Gone. Yes. Compassion, meat eating. All gone. Only truthfulness, still standing and shaking, so it is described. So therefore, on the strength, we have no capacity to perform austerity. Just if we too difficult. Oh, too difficult. We need taste. Immediately. Taste. Needs to be fun, you see. At least once a week, big fun. In this way, Prabhupada started his Sunday feast, right? Special preparations. Everything was special. Satsarupa Maharaj describes that he was just asking, when Prabhupada's asking, do you want any more, any more? So Satsarupa Maharaj didn't want to sound too lusty, so he didn't say sweets. He says, I'll have some rice. But even the rice had little cheese balls in them and cashews, and so even the rice was ecstatic. Huge feasts, somehow or other. That was the way to survive. That was Sunday, stuff yourself on the feast. Monday, still eat the feast. Tuesday, it's fine, still okay. Wednesday, whatever's kept in the fridge. Thursday, some leftovers. Friday, it's getting tough. But Saturday, it's almost Sunday feast. So like this. All arrangements arrangements of special mercy, just so that there would be taste. Yeah. So the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, is described as giving taste, because offenses are not considered, therefore very quickly some taste will emerge. And it's that taste that gives us the strength to carry on. Otherwise, we couldn't carry on, you see. It's like in some of the other sampradayas, there are many brahmanas who by birth are pious and who almost are capable of studying. Most of us, you know what I mean? Like, when was the last time you read a book of Srila Prabhupada? Okay. Yeah. So it's not that. It's just so Golokira Prima Dana Harinam Sankirtana, that Sankirtan movement that is descended from Goloka. That Sankirtan movement is the movement which is described as a transcendental festival. Word a song, every step a dance. It's about a festival, the transcendental festival of the spiritual world. So that is the core of this movement. And then there's Bhagavatam. That's the foundation. But the taste is needed. Yeah. We need Ratiyatra. No Ratiyatra. We need big kirtans. No big kirtans. No fun. Yes, so like this, we are trying to survive in this movement. Who is sure that they're going to do this their whole life? Many people may say, yes, I'm sure. But then again, really sure? Never any doubts? What do you do when doubts come? There can be different doubts. There can be doubts in the philosophy of Krishna consciousness. There can be doubts in, not in the philosophy, but in oneself. Will I be able to do it? That doubt. I believe in Krishna consciousness, but will I be able to do it for a whole life? Yeah. So, what to do? How to do so? Just simply turn to Lord Nityananda. And of course, Lord Nityananda is always engaged in devotional service. So the best way to turn to Lord Nityananda is through devotional service. Raghunath Das is the example of the person who wanted to join Lord Chaitanya's movement. Raghunath Das was from a very wealthy zamindar family, landowners, and who were collecting taxes from that land and paid to the Muslim government, but kept a huge amount of money themselves. And 500 years ago, it is said in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, they were earning 12 lakhs a month, 500 years ago, you know, when they were still talking in annas, paisas and annas, you know. Yes. I mean, inconceivably, fabulously wealthy. And his family was trying to do everything to keep Raghunath. So Raghunath at one point saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but he could not join him. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him, he said, just act as if you are interested in material life. And then keep your devotional mood internal. So when Raghunath started doing that, it went much better with his parents. And but still, they didn't trust him, so they were watching him. But then, Lord Nityananda, after Lord Chaitanya had taken sannyas, then Lord Chaitanya had promised his mother that he would stay in Jagannath Puri. So he sent Lord Nityananda to Bengal to preach in Bengal. And Lord Nityananda went there to Bengal, and it was a very ecstatic journey because he had a whole group of associates and they were doing very ecstatic kirtan, and in the middle of the kirtan, one suddenly got in a pose of Krishna, and they chanted one line of a song glorifying Krishna for 9 hours. And so in this way, it took a long time to reach to Bengal. And then when they moved, they really moved, completely absorbed in ecstasy. And then at one point they felt, are we really going the right direction? They said, no, you missed a turn. You have to go 10 kilometers back. Then they were going back the 10 kilometers, but they went 5 kilometers too far, and they missed a turn again. So it took a long time to make it. But eventually they came to Bengal. So Lord Nityananda, he was the preacher in Bengal. And Lord Chaitanya was sending Rupa and Sanatan and a few others to Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, these Goswamis, Nana Shastra, Vichara Naika Nipuno, Sadharma Samstapako, they wrote transcendental literatures to establish the principles, the true religious principles. What Lord Nityananda did was something totally different. Lord Nityananda was just dealing with the most fallen, and Lord Nityananda was just engaging everyone in chanting Hare Krishna. And it was just totally ecstatic. Lord Nityananda had started preaching when, after meeting Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Navadvip. That was, at that time, he was still a grihastha, Lord Chaitanya. That's before sannyas. So then at that time, they preached to Jagai and Madai. And we'll go there later. So that was while they're still grihasthas. Later, when Lord Chaitanya was in Puri and he sent Nityananda back to Bengal, yeah, at that time Nityananda was just preaching up a storm. Somehow or other, he wound up in the Saptagram region. That Saptagram region, Saptagram was a very large business area. It was a port based on a river. So a lot of trade was happening from Saptagram, and it was there, in the Saptagram area, that Hiranya and Govardhan Majumdar, the father of Raghunath Das and his uncle, lived. It is said that Haridas Thakur was not living so far from Saptagram, and that Haridas used to come there sometimes. Haridas visited the house of Hiranya and Govardhan Majumdar. And it is said that at that time, Raghunath Das was very small, or still young, at least a kid. So as a kid, he got some association of Haridas Thakur. Pretty good to get such kind of association. That association developed, and Raghunath Das subsequently developed a great desire to join Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But he could not. His family was guarding him and would not give him any opportunity. Then Lord Nityananda came to that Saptagram area and stayed there for 3 months and preached in that whole area for 3 months. During that time, Raghunath Das had the opportunity to go and meet him since he was nearby. And he brought, of course, his family sent like a whole escort with him so that everything was okay. And Raghunath Das, when he saw Nityananda, he paid his obeisance at a distance. And Nityananda immediately says, grab that man! Grab that thief! Now in India, when you say chor, you try it. I mean, you can try the experiment. You just go stand anywhere on the road, and you chant and you call out as loud as you can, "Chor!" Right? And see what happens. Within moments, there will be a few hundred people, right, around you. You know, where's the chor? It's a big thing. So as soon as Nityananda said "chor," oh, so the people, they grabbed the chor, and they brought the chor in front of Lord Nityananda. Fell on the ground. "So now I have you. Now I will punish you." And then he placed his lotus foot on the head of Raghunatha. And then he said, "You rascal, you've stolen away the opportunity for me to embrace you by offering obeisances at a distance. For that, I will punish you." And so then he had to do that chip rice festival. But it was in that connection with Lord Nityananda and doing that service for Lord Nityananda that somehow or other created the opening. After that, things changed. And after that, one day, he was acting like a businessman, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had instructed him, and his parents were a little more relaxed. And one day, he was with the family priest, his family initiating spiritual master, Yadunandan, who was a follower of Chaitanya. And then Yadunandan needed something from his house. And Raghunath said, "Oh, I will bring it, Guru Maharaj." He ran, he went. And instead of going east, he went south. He went in a different direction, he somehow or other escaping, and he managed to escape. And so, eventually, joined Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, that mercy of Lord Nityananda is the prerequisite. That comes first. First, Nittai Pada Binabai Radha Krishna Paitanai. If we are not serving the lotus feet of Nityananda, we will not be able to approach Radha and Krishna. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna. So one can also not approach Lord Chaitanya without the mercy of Lord Nityananda. So we are serving. And of course that quote of Srila Prabhupada that in the Jumna Maharaj mentioned this morning, the one about if you want the mercy of Krishna, you need the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. If you want the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, you need the mercy of Lord Nityananda. If you want the mercy of Lord Nityananda, you have to preach to all the Jagais and Madhais in this world. Yeah. And we see that Srila Prabhupada came in between. Srila Prabhupada came there for us and made it even more accessible, made it even adjusted things for the modern world. All right, don't worry about it. It's okay. You have your baths attached, an attached bathroom, because you don't want to go outside in the fields. All right. You can have. Of course, you know, the whole house has become a bathroom. See, that is the thing. The moment you have a bathroom in your house, technically speaking, your house has become a bathroom. That's it. It's all part of the bathroom now. Yeah. It's also like some people, they take their eating utensils and wash them in the bathroom. Now, I have absolutely no objection if any eating utensils, any cup or whatever, goes into the bathroom, it's fine. But it can't come back out. Whatever goes in there, that's it. It stays there. That's Vedic culture. But now, Baba Deku. Ah, Bada Techt. Oh, yes, yes. Pay extra. Yes, yes, yes. Baka Brahman, no problem. Bada Techt. Yes. Rather better Bada Techt than in the winter going outside, rainy season, under the gamcha, you know, going to the railway line in the morning and passing there. I don't know why in India, in the villages, everyone goes to the railway line. I have never understood. But when you drive on the train in the morning, you see all these people sitting at the side of the railway line. Oh, my God. Ay, ay, ay. Yes, it's true. Anyway, Lord Nityananda. So we can see, you know, like Vedic culture is difficult. And Prabhupada, he adjusted things. Right? He made it possible for us to fit in. It's very interesting. Prabhupada is a faithful servant of his spiritual master. Prabhupada was repeating what his spirit, but then some things he also adjusted. Like in the Gaudiya Mat, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur never preached four regulative principles. That was understood, you know, it was explained that no sinful behavior. That was clear. Yes. But it wasn't spelled out. It wasn't spelled out like no meat, fish, or eggs, no gambling, no intoxication. That wasn't spelled out, nor did we have to promise it. If someone just, many people, they say, no meat. Mm-hmm. I never let them off. I always make them promise the fish and the eggs, just in case. You know, pani phal. Huh? In Bengal, they say pani phal. You know, fish is pani phal. That means, yeah, fruit from the water. Fruit de mer, in French also. Huh? Fruit de mer. Yes, yes, and then there's all the fish on your plate. Freedom, fruit from this, from the ocean. That's what it means. Italian also to say it like that? No? No, just checking. Frutta del mare. See? Tutti frutti del mare. Yeah. So we can see, no? Prabhupada made it clear, you know, like put boundaries for modern, for Torakali, for Jagai and Madai, right? He put clear boundaries, yes. And it's not that in India, Jagai and Madai are not there. Jagai and Madai were in India 500 years ago. It's like Prabhupada said, India will be the best and India will be the worst. As a Buddha. Will be the best and India will be the worst. What to do? So it's our job to be the best. Yes. Anyway, so Lord Nityananda's mercy is, and Lord Chaitanya's mercy, is particularly there, making so many adjustments, allowing us. It's very interesting because the International Society for Krishna Consciousness changed Vrindavan. You know, this was a sleepy town, not much going on. Some temples were there, some worship, but if you would go to Loy Bazaar in the afternoon, the shopkeepers would all be asleep. You'd have to wake them up. Now it's not like that anymore, right? They're like, yeah. It's like the town woke up. And not only did it wake up, but all the Western things are here now. Everything is here. Before, everyone was trying to keep that away. But now, it's fully here. So, yeah, it's terrible sounds, but what can be done? It's my fault. Hare Krishna. Yeah, there's a big hum. Anyway, we have to do some. Yeah. But you are getting a new one, no? I can do that. I don't need this thing.
Okay, for now I talk to the microphone works. So then you get it going. So
Krishna. Hare Krishna. Anyway. So Lord Nityananda, so the first point I wanted to make is that we have to go through Nityananda. And going to Nityananda means to serve. So Srila Prabhupada, as a representative of Nityananda, gave us the mercy, he gave us knowledge, he made it simple, he engaged everyone in chanting Hare Krishna, he arranged for a lot of prasadam, he spelled out certain boundaries really clear so that we could not somehow or other make up some excuse. Like, one time, Tamal Krishna Maharaj was in a particular country somewhere in the Far East, and he asked, and they offered him a cake. And Maharaj said, "Is this vegetarian? No meat, fish, or eggs?" He said, "Yes, no meat, fish, or eggs." He said, "Then what is it made of?" "It was made of insects." Dhananjaya explains that he was seeing the devotees from America for the first time, and he was so impressed by them that he went back and he wanted to give them a gift, so he brought them a box with eggs. So many things like that, you know. Just to establish four regulative principles is a major effort. A major effort, actually. We can see. And next to that, by taste and mercy, we are able to do so. So Srila Prabhupada took it down to basics and then engaged everyone in service. That's what Nityananda is doing, assisting Nityananda in serving the Lord. Bhakti was translated as devotional service. So in this way, we can see how Srila Prabhupada embodied the mood of Lord Nityananda. Yes, come in. Yes. Oh la la. Okay, viens. Vite. They're amazing. Yeah. So, in this way, it is by service that we assist Lord Nityananda and that we attract the mercy of Lord Nityananda by devotional service in this movement. The whole movement is clearly meant to reach out to everyone, and particularly the most fallen. Yeah, very short, Jagai Madai. The first point was that Jagai was forgiven. the Lord. Lord Chaitanya was coming to kill Bhosti's brothers after they had attacked Lord Nityananda, but it was Nityananda who stopped Lord Chaitanya and said, Jagai, he saved me. When Madai was trying to attack me for a second time, then Jagat stopped him. Ah, Lord Chaitanya spontaneously embraced Jagai, and Jagai got the mercy, and then Madai got no mercy. And Madai goes, but what about me? We did everything together, and I'm scared. His brother is like, just like totally. And his Madai is looking and missing out. It's only Lord Nityananda, if he forgives you. Lord Nityananda, no problem. He forgave Madai, and he embraced Madai, and then Madai also, you know, in ecstasy, etc. And then they said, but what about all the offenses that we have committed to so many people because we did not know we were drunk? We were always drunk. So as a result, we offended so many people, have no idea who we offended. We must have offended thousands of people without knowing. Therefore, they were advised, start this bathing ghat and wash the feet of anybody who comes. So they did that. That was one thing. But then one day, Madai came back to Lord Nityananda and said to Lord Nityananda that, I know, my Lord, you have forgiven me. That is your costless mercy. But I cannot forgive myself. In other words, you know, Madai was walking around with a big guilt complex, a serious one. He could not forgive himself. Then Nityananda said, my dear Madai, from my perspective, you know, from my perspective, you are just like a child. And when a child hits his father, father doesn't take it very serious. So you know, it's not so serious. In this way, Madai became a bit more pacified. It helped. He got over it a bit. And we can see that we also may still internally in our mind carry our traumas, carry our frustration, we may still feel, but I'm so fallen. A devotee will get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, surely. Surely a devotee will get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda. But am I a devotee? You also have that sometimes? Huh? That like, am I a devotee? Where you doubt it. Will I get the mercy? I don't know. Yeah, so we have this doubt. Trivika Maharaj, he once said, if you have doubts, then don't dwell on these doubts. Instead, look at your faults and try to correct them. And by doing so, your doubts will disappear. That's very deep. A deep point. So, the mercy of Lord Nityananda is there for anybody and everyone, but at one point we have to align with that mercy. We have to change our lives and we have to now live a life of purity, as Srila Prabhupada said, four regulated principles, and then chant 16 rounds. Minimum. Why 16 rounds? Why not 16,000 rounds? Yeah. Like this, we need to We need to work for purification. We're engaging in service. Anartapasamam saksat yogam bhakti yoga madokshaje. This service is purifying us. And we also try to now act purely, like Jagai and Madai did. They were now serving. They were now trying to act purely. So this is something of importance. This morning, in the Jumna Maharaj brought up this Dandabhanga pastime, you know, the breaking of the Danda of Nityananda, and he did it good, like three pieces, and throw them in the river and all that. Now, generally speaking, it brings up a theme that Lord Chaitanya was playing a double role. On the one hand, he was playing a role of conforming to Vedic culture and the culture of Varna Ashram. And within that, he had taken the position of a sannyasi. And so he was following sannyas dharma. And as a result, he was strictly living a life by rules. And then other times, we see that he is transcendental to these things and that he acts transcendental to these things just based on loving relationships. So this is a recurring theme in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya, that we see him on this platform of following the Vedic rules and regulations, and that he just acts on the platform of bhakti and responding to bhakti. And like he was not meant to meet his family members again. The wife he never met. But he was also not supposed to go back to his village. So he didn't go back to his village, but Nityananda sent him in the wrong direction, sent him to Shantipur, which is close enough, and then the whole village came. And then the whole village was there, and there was his mother. And then what was he going to say? And it's like, you know, in those days, the sannyasi would not go back to his mother. So that was arranged, so that wasn't his fault. It was Nityananda tricked him. So in this way, he broke the normal etiquette of a sannyasi, but at the same time, he was satisfying all these devotees who were in too much separation. So this theme recurs again and again in the pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Nityananda wanted Lord Chaitanya to act on the pure transcendental platform and forget to act according to etiquette, you know what I mean? Yeah. Just act on the platform of pure love. And that's why in the Jumna Maharaj is saying this breaking of the danda means you unleash the pure love, because at that point, no longer bound on the platform of etiquette, but then acting on the platform of pure love. Anyway, I wanted to just add that, you know, when you explained that this morning. Yeah. So I will stop at in 15 minutes, because I don't want to compete with other programs and move them. So Jayadvaya Tomorrow has a program starting at 5. And anyway, that's too late now. Because now I've sort of like laid out a lecture in a particular way. You see, I it's like you go, you start like somewhere at the bottom of the hill, you go up the hill, and then you sort of come down the hill. So I'm already on the downslope. I'm coming down right now. And that's good, because then I can still do a little kirtan in the temple, which is also fun. And not an official kirtan, no need to bring all this. It's just humble kirtan. The best things are never recorded. You know that? There's some in my whole life, I've been recorded everywhere and anywhere, and sometimes it was not recorded, and then that was the best ever. So try for that. But I'm almost choking today, so, but still, I want to sing a little bit for the Lord, but I don't want to be in competition. You're supposed to be with Jai Vaitama. Yeah. I can't do that. Sorry. I have to be a little spontaneous. Yes. Because on Nityananda's appearance day, we have to do some spontaneous devotional service. Yeah. Something extra. But I wasn't sure if I was able to do it. So I considered two options. One was go on the 5 o'clock Harinam and lead that one. Or the other one was going to the temple for a kirtan. What should I do? But then I killed Jayadvaita Maharshi's program. See, that's not good. Just stay home then. It's a Chinese proverb. I dreamt 1,000 new paths. I woke up and walked the old one. Anyhow, so this mercy of Lord Nityananda is an ongoing. It is not just an introduction into Krishna consciousness. That somehow or other, in the middle of our most fallen situation, here's the Lord, and He pushes us up. No, it's as much today, after so many years in Krishna consciousness. We still rely on it. We only survive by that mercy. Surviving by the mercy of Lord Nityananda. Let us understand that thoroughly, in depth. That I wanted to say. And then, what else I want to say? Yes, well, there in Saptagram, so many devotees became involved. And one of them was Udarandatta Thakur. And Udarandatta Thakur is in the Prabhupada is in the family lineage of Udarandatta Thakur. So in that way, Udarandatta Thakur is special. He was a Suvarnavarnik, a jeweler. So he supplied all the jewels. Nityananda would just cover himself in jewels everywhere. Or a few rings on every finger. Glitter, glitter, you know, and chains and everything. And some thief saw him and thought, like, whoa, you know, this guy's loaded. And if we got this, we've got a mage, you know. So a gang was following him, but and his kirtan party, but it never worked. Because, you know, they would go on the dark moon night and they would sharpen their swords and daggers and just and choppers. But the first night they were in ambush, in a bush. And then they woke up the next morning and they'd all fallen asleep. So everyone accused everyone. But in the end, that happened. Everyone, the boss said, don't worry. There will be a next opportunity. And they waited again and followed him. And then he was staying in this house and they were ready. And then suddenly these soldiers were there. Big soldiers, like, big arms, big weapons. Whoa. And then the boss
said, don't worry, don't worry. The king who gave him all that wealth must have given him soldiers as well. But sooner or later, these soldiers will have to go back to the king. So just wait. We'll get him. And the third time, dark moon night, Amavasya, pitch black, you know, no electricity. Pitch black outside. Yeah. Dogs. Dogs howling. Ooh. Intense night. And that night, in the darkness of night, they were lying there in ambush, ready to attack the house where Nityananda was. And then suddenly, they went blind. They all went blind and they fell in a ditch. The one walked into thorn bushes and it was a total mess. Some broke bones and somehow or other. Then the leader of the dacoits, who was a Brahmana, he understood. He is the SPOG. Supreme Personality of God, in case you missed out on that one. He's the Supreme Personality of God. So then this dacoit comes into the room and everybody knew him. Oh my God. Oh, this guy is here. Look. Everybody. There was a dark cloud hanging over him. He emanated darkness. The whole room became dark. Just his presence. If you have some big gunda, he brings darkness with him. And this big gunda, he just walked up to Nityananda and everyone was just like, and then he fell flat on the ground, done, surrendered his life. Then later he would go preaching and do some gundagiri to the, go and preach to the dacoits. So from time to time, he'd bring some dacoits to Lord Nityananda and force these dacoits to bow down before Lord Nityananda. Yeah. Bow down. In this way, he made many devotees. So that's also interesting because everyone can go back to their own community. You have your own community, your own people, your people. Go back to your people. How can I preach? Now, some people can preach to anybody. But otherwise, just preach to your own people.
But I don't have any people. I'm all alone.
Well, okay. Anyway, Satsarup Maharaj wrote a nice book about one brahmachari who started preaching to the mice. Chota. Huh? Pretty good. Have you read it? If you haven't read it, you have to read it. I mean, it's really good. It's like he enters into the whole mice community and it's the whole thing. And there's all kinds of politics as well. There's even some sort of GBC. So it's worth reading. It's worth reading. Absolutely. You have to read it. Yeah. Nimai the mouse. Nimai in the mouth or something. Anyway, Chota. I know there's four. The first one is Nimai in the mouth or something, right? And then Chota is there. Yeah. That's after the preaching. Like, then he's made Chota. Anyway, like that. Yes, we preach. You know, there's always ways. Distribute prasadam, do harinam, somehow or other. Somehow or other, let us do something to give Krishna consciousness to this crazy world. And sometimes, Yeah, if we don't preach, well, Maya is preaching. Have you noticed? I mean, you know, we are like, excuse me, would you be interested to hear something about Krishna consciousness? No time. Yeah. And Maya's in your face, you know what I mean? She's on your phone, she's everywhere, she's working overtime, you know, like, and her devotees, they are serious, they're dedicated. Yeah. So if we don't preach, Maya will. And so the madness is increasing. It's not that the madness is staying the same. The madness of Kali Yuga is increasing and increasing. Now, it's been Kali Yuga for quite a while, right? But don't think it's just staying, just standing still. And since we got the internet in our life, my God, you know, I mean, Kali has a powerful tool. Right? It's every day in your head. How many times a day? And if you don't pay attention, the thing buzzes, you know. God, makes noises, you know, flashes, there's all kinds of things. Then it's got algorithms, you know, it knows what you've looked at before, and we're going to give you more. I'm hooked. Yeah, so by now, you know, there is a major addiction in the whole world, including the Hare Krishna movement. It's just an incredible phone addiction. I mean, we can get saves with a time lock on it and just put your phone in there and just lock it away, especially in the evening. Lock it away. But just put it in there. Digital detox and all that. Yes. Anyway, so we can see that there's a lot to do, a lot to do. This movement has to really go forward and carry that mercy of Lord Nityananda forward. I could have told more Nityananda stories, but I didn't do that. I tried to go in depth on some of the stories by taking some deeper points there. And drive them home and show our dependence on Lord Nityananda and show how we are. Yeah, how, as Lord Nityananda becomes the menial servant of Lord Chaitanya, as Lord Nityananda is always glorifying Lord Chaitanya, as Lord Nityananda is engaging in Harinam, as Lord Nityananda is just going door to door, as Lord Nityananda is, in the Jumna Maharaj spoke about opening, he knocked on a door and a punch came out, right? Of course. And I opened the door, or I knocked on a door, and this huge guy in black leather opened the door. And he said, "Where are you?" And I couldn't speak anymore. I was just like, and I had a book in my hand. So he grabs the book and throws some money at me. Said, "Get out of here." So you just never know. Never know what will happen. It's just amazing things will happen. Yes, miracles will happen, really. If you knock on doors. I knocked on one door and I found the missing link. a species between the monkey and the human being. I didn't tell anybody, you know. I don't. Oh gosh. I agree. No, without the jokes, and when you give a talk in a room, it's different than when you sit in a temple on a Vyasa. It becomes a lot more informal, you know, in the living room. So, internet viewers, please appreciate this is a living room talk on the sofa. Okay, so we're relaxed at home. I don't have a table, otherwise I would put my feet on it. I actually have a picture of Srila Prabhupada with his feet on the table. There you go. It's authorized. Lotus feet. Yes. Anyway, the essence is that we take up the Yuga Dharma, and that is the mission of Lord Chaitanya Nityananda, sun and moon rising together. Yeah, Nityananda Sahodito. Godadoya Puspadanta Chitta Sando Tamonado. So Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, the sun brings us the inspiration, brings us the energy that drives everything. And the moon is Yechayai Jagatajurai, cools everything down, cools down our envy, cools down our crazy desires. How? By this service. Yeah, Lord Nityananda, as an active preacher, he met a Buddhist somewhere in the Himalayas, asked him for some water, and there was no response because the Buddhist was in deep meditation, and Lord Nityananda kicked him in the face. Yeah, he did. Gave him the mercy of his lotus foot. You have to be a little transcendental to take that one. But that's what he did. Yeah. We heard about the Avaduta this morning. And so I'll leave it at that. And I was planning to stop at 4:30. Don't want to change that. So I thank you all for coming here. And Q&A, I also want to, because we do so much Q&A. So we'll do Q&A on Monday. Oh, Zoom tomorrow. Yeah. Zoom tomorrow at 3:00. Sunday. Yeah, so look, I think it's 12. Yeah. Monday. So thank you all very much. I think someone brought some prasadam somewhere, isn't it? No? Who's going to distribute that? You. No, I'm saying, yeah, the team is ready? Okay, well then the team should really get ready. Then I'll take one question just so that the team can cut the cake. Anyone has a question? In the very back, there's a hand. It always has to be in the back. Can you just do it like that and I'll repeat your question? Loud. Just speak. You can do it. Any fortune? Faults. Yeah, well, you know, then just go to hell. I don't mean that in a bad way, you know. I mean, I know it may sound pretty nasty. No, I don't mean it in a nasty way at all. But, you know, Krishna gives us the choice. He really gives us the choice. You know, it's entirely up to us. Take it or leave it. And yes, we can bring the horse to water, but the horse has to drink. So we can say, chant Hare Krishna, because this beautiful Maha Mantra is so filled with mercy and it will just change your life. So therefore, please chant it. Yeah? And if you have some faults, then take it very seriously and work on it by chanting the holy name.
Well, no, I can't chant. I don't want to chant. You know, leave me alone.
Yeah, then what can I do? Or I used to chant, you know, a long, long time ago, but then I lost my beat bag. And you see my point. So it's like, you can't just say there's nothing I can do. You have to do something. Otherwise, like I said before, I won't repeat it because I'll get in trouble. You know, it's like someone will make an abuse case against me. That was fun. Is the cake ready? Otherwise, I'll take one more question. Always in the back. Back. Take it back.
You mentioned the Vrindavan pastime.
Mm-hmm.
And you said that Rajasani was kind of followed the Vedic principle. But then also he had the side was transcendental. And I'm just wondering, sometimes within our society, it seems like we're taking the transcendental kind of aspect too far. And I think sometimes we get in trouble for it. So what should we do? Like how can we, because was saying how Jagai and Madai, they were, you know, personally instructed, oh, you do this, you know, to rectify yourself. But sometimes we don't have that within our society. So.
Yeah, well, you know, like, you know, if we give an inch, right, our minds are such that if you give our mind an inch, then it will take a mile. And so on. So we have to be careful. As soon as we start to relax on standards, then we become, we don't know where to stop. That's the thing. You know, if we relax a little, but once the floodgates open, then can't close it anymore. That is the difficulty. And I don't know. I think as a movement, we have all kinds of varieties. From the early days on, there was the East Coast and the West Coast. New York was kind of trying to follow rules and standards. And, you know, San Francisco was, you know. And it's like that East Coast, West Coast mood. right? It has always been there. So we've always had, like, and we still have, we have people who are more inclined towards standards, rules, this, that. Some are even going towards fundamentalism. And fundamentalism is where we try to take a whole system of belief and try to reduce it to something very simple. Eh? And then everything becomes black and white. Right? So we have that. Then we have total liberalism on the other side. You know, anything goes. You know what I mean? You decide what you are. You decide what you like. And, you know, you decide. You decide what you want to do. There was a group of devotees. It started in a German-speaking area, and they invented freie bhakti, which translates, you may guess already, as free bhakti. Da-da-da-da! Free bhakti. Just let it flow. You know, just let the bhakti flow natural. Yeah, it's of course, the problem is it's not only bhakti that's going to flow. There's a few other things that are going to flow as well. It is a battle with our lower nature. Also, can you stop standing there with that camera? Hey, you're blocking the person who asked the question. And then I'm making eye contact. And then what happened is this, is that... There was a monastery of nuns, and they sent a group of psychologists in there to reconnect the nuns with their true feelings. Then at one point, one elder nun kissed a younger one, and then, you know, the whole thing collapsed. And it's like within weeks, there was no more monastery. They all just dropped everything. Yeah, they were surprised that this happened. And what the psychologist said, we said that they didn't consider the inherent evil in people. Yeah, or as we would say, the lower nature in people. So because there is a lower nature, therefore, we have to always be on guard. I know myself. You know yourself. You know, we should be on guard. If I'm not on guard, then my lower nature takes over. If I give my laziness an inch, it wants to take a bit extra, and so on. So a certain amount of self-discipline is required in spiritual life. And therefore, it's good to set boundaries until we are totally spontaneously absorbed in service. Then, automatically, there will be no sinful activity. Okay, this is it. Everyone got their prasadam now? They start getting it? So then we end the program, and then... I thank you, and we see you again tomorrow, if you wish, at 3:00. We'll do it again. But don't come too early, because I was trying to take a little nap and before, so tired, because last night I didn't sleep. And it's time to take a little nap, and there's everyone. Then, plof, carpet number one. Plof, carpet number two. Plough, oh man, I was like counting every carpet. I have problems sleeping at night. All right, thank you very much. Shishi Nityananda Trayodashi Ki Jai. Ananta koti vaishnava vinda ki jai.